There is a world all around us that we simply can't see. But what if we could explore beyond the limits of our senses? Let's slow down time. Fix your gaze. Reveal the unseen. And don't blink.
Sunlight's kind of the primary source for everything that we see. And it's a broadband source. It's spitting out at all these different wavelengths. A small fraction of that is what we call the visible portion. It's what our eyes are sensitive to. I think there's strong connection points to ultimately think about the study of astronomy as kind of a play on seeing, you know, because ultimately that's what they're doing. They're detecting light across all different wavelengths to figure out what's going on.
The world that we perceive is a very narrow window. If we could see more of the spectrum of light than we normally do as human beings, I think the world would be really interesting. Cameras can capture infrared and ultraviolet and X-rays to look into the cosmos and see some very beautiful things that we, to our own eyes, will never be able to see.
What if we just expanded the range of wavelengths that we could see over? But if you could see in the infrared, you would see warm things. Let's say we're in a pitch black room and you look around and you don't see anybody. But if you could see in the infrared, you'd be able to kind of see those warm bodies. Being able to see ultraviolet, say, how would that change our perception of the world around us? A good first order rule is UV kills. So a big part of what makes Earth's atmosphere so special is that it filters out those wavelengths.
And try again.
Ultraviolet light gives you sunburns, it can cause cataracts, it can do a lot of nasty things, but when you're dealing with flowers, if you hit them with just ultraviolet light, flowers and a lot of other natural objects will fluoresce beautifully, almost magically. And so when we step beyond our regular perceptions, whether it's just looking more closely at something or exploring it in a different kind of light, because we've never seen it before, it becomes fascinating. It becomes something that our imagination might not have even predicted to be possible.
That is so cool.
I think it's absolutely amazing when you start to recognize how different vision is for every creature. So when it comes to cats, cats have great night vision because cats are predators that hunt at dawn and at dusk. Red and green are indistinguishable to them. They're sort of the same color. You can use modern technology to be able to make red and green tones exactly the same. And then you have a sense of what a cat can see.
That's a hidden message within that flower that we can't see with our own eye. A bee sees light and color differently than we do. If you take just a plain white flower and look at that same flower in ultraviolet, you will see a pattern in that flower that an insect can see. In the case of this flower, it will see a very dark center that to us was bright yellows and greens. We can explore that with camera gear, but we could never see that with our own eyes. When I take a photograph, I've had people come up to me and say, "Is that real?" The answer is yes, absolutely. That is real. That is the world we live in. Beyond what our eyes can capture, beyond what our everyday lives are. That's what fascinates me photographically. That's what fascinates me to explore things using the camera simply as a tool to see beyond my own limitations.